All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Chupacabra Tutorials channel. I'm your host, Larry, and today we're back to show you how to hook up your PS5 Dualsense Controller to your Windows PC via Bluetooth. So in order to do this, all you have to do is make sure that you've got your controller right here. It's charged and everything. And if you need to reset it because it still talks to your PS5, you might need to press a safety pin into this extra little hole back here for about a count of 8 to 10 seconds with something like a safety pin or a paperclip. And then once this is completely reset and ready to go, then we can pair it with your computer. So open up on your Windows PC over here, open up the Bluetooth and other devices settings. It's inside of your big list of all the devices connected to your computer in the main Windows settings. And this is the place where you'd find things like where your printers are set up and installed, what other things are connected to your computer, like your mouse or your keyboard. What we want is the Bluetooth and other devices at the top. Toggle on your Bluetooth device if you've got one built in, and then click on the Add Bluetooth or Other Devices button at the top. This will open up a pop-up asking what kind of device. We'll just say Bluetooth. And now it'll start searching for the device somewhere near your computer. Then at the same time, on this PS5 controller, we want to hit the PlayStation button here and also the Share button, which is this little one on the side of the touchpad. We want to click both of those at the exact same time and hold them until the light starts to blink. See how it's starting to flash rapidly? That means this is in discoverable mode, so something can connect to it. From there, we want to click yes and click this one. A little wireless controller popped up on the list, and then it should connect, and bingo bango, you are done. This bad boy is hooked up to your computer, and now you can set it up with the drivers of your choice. I know that DS4 Windows works. I have a tutorial on that available. And then I also know that the Steam client actually has a pair of drivers for this that work pretty well as well. So that's it for this one, ladies and gentlemen. I've been your host, Larry. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you have any questions about this process, throw those in the video comments below. And until next time, have a good one. Bye.